Hi everyone, how are we all? I hope you're all well. Welcome back to what would usually be my spring capsule wardrobe video, but I sort of wanted to roll three videos into one. So you're going to be getting that, but also you're going to be getting a bit of a wardrobe declutter. I feel like I haven't had a declutter in a while. I feel like I rarely purchase clothing that I don't need or doesn't really fit me, or, you know, 12 months later I don't like. But we're at that point where it's been a while. I feel like there are a few clothing items that I can shed that I haven't worn as much in the last 12 months as I probably should have. I can donate them to charity, they can go to a new home. So we're gonna do a bit of decluttering, and then also I'm gonna share with you the few items that I picked up to be part of my spring capsule wardrobe as well. I did a bit of vintage shopping. I'm very, very excited about some of these new things. You might have seen some of these items in my latest 10x10 video. I'll link that up there in the corner for you. That was like a spring edit, so you've got a little sneak peek if you want to see them on, but I'm also going to share them here with you. Whew, what a mouthful. Also, I'm wearing my leggings today. Hashtag not pregnant. I just had a doll for lunch and I feel pregnant. I'm so full. My belly is so hard. And so I went for the Lululemon leggings, and yeah, I've got on some very comfortable clothing today, because I was like, we're decluttering, we're getting involved, we're doing some cleaning, I wanted to be comfy. So let's do this. The first action point here is to get everything out, give it a good clean. Something to note about our shoes: while this whole outbreak has been going on, I actually haven't really been using any of these shoes. I've just been wearing my trainers or my chunky boots, and they both now officially live downstairs in the hallway. We haven't got a lot of space for shoes, but there's probably enough space for Mark to keep two pairs down there, me to keep two pairs down there, so we're not bringing them into the house. So that is something to note. And I'll be doing the same with any shoes that I wear over the coming weeks. So disclaimer out of the way, let's do this. Cleaning done, the first thing I always get on with are shoes. For me, I have the fewest shoes. It's a very easy category for me to sort. I have these UGG slippers from a Christmas gift guide. I actually already have a pair of UGG slippers. I know, outrageous. So I'm keeping these till a rainy day when those ones literally have a hole in the bottom. So I think I'm gonna pop these into storage. I think I need to have an honest word with myself. The Chloe Susanna boots are the most expensive boots I've ever bought. And I just don't wear them as much as I should, considering the price tag of these. Over the years, I've had a couple of people email me and ask if I'm selling them. So I think I need to sit down, have a bit of a word with myself and think about these. And if I do pop them for sale, I'll pop them on Depop and then we can raise some money for charity. So I think these might be going on a charity sale Depop pile. The Acne Jensen boots and the Whistles leopard print boots, I think I'm gonna pop these both into storage. I just haven't worn this shape of shoe. Wow, that's really hard to say, very much this year. I've tended to go more for like a Western, like actually with a bit of a heel boot. So I need to think about these next season, but I still adore both of these. They're just gonna pop them into storage. These are definitely my most worn boots of the season. These Topshop snake print ones, and then these Ganni ones. These are probably my most worn, along with my And Other Stories, the chunky, like big worker boot. But like I mentioned, they're downstairs. So definitely keeping both of those. Then finally, I've got the Dear Francis boots. Just a great dress up boot to have. So I don't tend to have these in the front row. These are like a little back row special for me. And then my Vans trainers. I have to say, I haven't worn these as much, I think because I've had the worker boots. So I'm gonna pop these back in just as a flat shoe option. I don't think it's time for sandals yet necessarily, but this capsule wardrobe will hopefully take me to the summertime. So I have got my Lock sandals out of storage, and then also these Sam Edelman, just these flat slip-ons. I wore these so much last year. And the Gucci loafers, a classic. So it's given me a couple more kind of casual shoe options, but also fancy shoe options as well. Okay, next I'm gonna put in like a bit of a secret category that usually lives here behind my jumpers. It might get moved around slightly, but it's my category of hoodies. And these are hoodies that I slob around the house in. So they're just things that I wear basically every day. There's like two Glossier ones, a Bon Appetit one that I just absolutely adore, one that says Saturday on it from Whistles. So I think I'm gonna put them kind of to the side for now. Let's just stick them down here, but these are gonna go somewhere, maybe a little bit easier to grab, because I can imagine there's not gonna be as much knitwear in here now. You know what, had a change of heart. I'm gonna go through the hanging things first. And there was just way too much stuff hanging here. It was getting a bit like, ugh, couldn't find things. So let's do some editing. The first thing that is 100% going back in is my And Other Stories. This is my leather dress. In fact, I might not hang this. I might put this under my bed with my like occasion wear pieces, only because it's more of an occasion wear piece for me. That makes sense for it to live down there with its friends. It doesn't need to be hung necessarily. It has a new home. So many coats. Whew, this is heavy. One thing you might have seen earlier is my Ganni dress with the orange flowers on. Love that. Friend wore it to a wedding, I think. And I was gonna wear it to a wedding. So she'd given it back to me, she dry cleaned it. But of course the wedding is canceled and that's fine. It's been postponed later on in the year. So I popped that under my bed as well with the rest of my occasion wear pieces, just so that is nice and safe there. So jackets. I always like to have like one black coat in there. So I'm gonna put my Whistles. This is the black pea coat. I'm gonna stick that in. My big fluffy Whistles number. I feel like it's time to go into hibernation. Bit too hot for that. Same goes for this Whistles one. And same goes for the Arquette one. This has done me good. Like so good, I'm gonna check the pockets before I put it away because this always has my AirPods in it. This has been such a bloody brilliant coat. I've worn this so much, but I think it's time for my like mini Patagonia to come back into play. I definitely don't need something as big these days. So these two are new jackets and they're both vintage purchases. So this one you would have seen in my 10x10. This is a vintage Max Mara, like a swing jacket, and I just adore the shape of it. I adore the color of it. It's just so flattering. And then this one is a vintage Burberry trench. Oh my word, I love the color of this. It's like a little bit cooler than a lot of other things in my wardrobe. So it's nice to have a bit of a different tone in there. But yeah, really like this number. Three jackets feels like a good amount. And then I think I'm gonna put my little mini Patagonia. This has been in storage, but I'm just gonna pop this in with my sports stuff because when spin gets back up again, this will be the type of thing that I just like throw on when I go to a class. But I don't think I need this right now. So gonna pop that in there. Okay, the other things that I had hanging up, my Realization Pass skirt, goes without saying, that's going back in. I just adore that thing. Then I have some shirts. So this is a cream silk shirt. This is another vintage number. I picked this up from Retold Vintage. I forgot to say, my Burberry trench is from Wear Not New Vintage. And then this Max Mara jacket was also from Wear Not New. But I really love Retold Vintage as well. So this is a newer purchase and I love the shape of it. I love the sheen on it. I just love a cream shirt. It's just, oh, crisp. This one is from And Other Stories, and I think I'm just gonna pop it into storage just so I can swap it in for something new. Same with the And Other Stories turtleneck. I just feel like mixing it up a bit. Oh, this is newer from Arquette. Very kindly gifted, and such a nice, really simple, basic with a twist number. I'm gonna pop this in. Again, something that I wore in the 10x10, if you wanna see that on. It's the perfect like dressy top with jeans top. Obviously not a top for right now, but hopefully something that I'll be able to crack out in the warmer months. Even though it's black, it's a light fabric, it's cool. And then this from Equipment. And for me, this is more of like a winter thing. I always picture wearing this like over winter, winter parties. So I'm gonna pop this into storage because I have been through my storage and I've actually got quite a few shirts I want to put back in. Speaking of which, I'm actually going to pop those bits back in. So these were just items that were in storage from last spring that just need to go back to their rightful home. So this was from Retail Vintage last year, and this is a really nice oversized blazer, extremely creased. I'm going to get my steamer out, give everything a good steam, freshen it up, get my debobbler out if anything needs that. But I feel like that's a nice jacket wardrobe. I've got more of a crisp white, I've got like a yellowy cream, I've got like a trench stony kind of color, and then a black jacket. So that is all of my jacket needs done. And then one thing that I always miss when it's not in there is my oversized white And Other Stories shirt. And then I've also got the Arquette black oversized cotton shirt. So they're going back in. Another thing that I always miss is this frame polka dot shirt. I feel like I'm always wearing this in videos, but I just feel very like polished whenever I put this on, so that's going back in. And then because I like to be fully stocked on my basics, this is a frame silk shirt, but short sleeved. And then also this is from, oh, is this from Frame as well? I picked this up for Sri Lanka. I'll pop the little vlog for that in the corner. And this was like a linen short sleeved, but a white shirt. So I feel like these will be good as it gets a little bit warmer if I don't want to wear a long sleeve number. So those are all of my new additions that have gone back in. So the items I've taken from storage that have gone back in, and also the handful of new items, mostly vintage this time, which is very exciting, that are also going back in. So now I just need to arrange my jean, knitwear, and t-shirt piles into something here, but also condense it down. It's obviously going to be getting a bit warmer, so I definitely don't need as much knitwear as I previously had still out. So I think what I'm going to do is rearrange it all, shove it back in, and speed up the whole thing. So that is it. I've rearranged things a little bit. I will talk you through. I've obviously got all of my jackets and coats here, my shirts, my one and only skirt. It's the huge. Then I've got kind of casual shoes, more of my boots. I've got jeans here with black t-shirts and white t-shirts behind it. My thermals used to live there, but I'm popping those in storage. And you know what? I didn't actually use them the whole winter. Climate change is real, people. I moved some of my knitwear around, so my heaviest pieces of knitwear, a lot of those items I've put into storage because it's heating up here. Like, we don't need super chunky knits anymore so much, so I've just rearranged them. I've just got a couple of like cardigans, a few more of my lighter chunky knits. Then I've got a few more of my knits up here. Again, just putting the few that I don't think I'll wear over the next couple of months into storage so they'll be ready for next winter. And then I actually had some space to have this out instead of tucked behind things, which is probably a good thing. We're all working from home, we're all trying to stay indoors, and I've been living in really comfy, cozy hoodies. And so actually I've just got those up at the top, which is nice because normally they're hidden behind things. They're a bit of a faff to get out. So actually everything is very easy for me to see. I didn't take any of my summer bags out because I love this LM one and I picture me wearing this the most out of all of them for the next couple of months. And also we're staying inside for the foreseeable, so that's cool. So I've tried not to take out as many bits as I normally would and just have a real edit here. Like, these are really my favorite bits, things I can actually see me using over the next 3 months. But before we go, as I mentioned, I have had a bit of a clear out. So I've gone through every single item of clothing that I own, and I'm gonna buy some of those vacuum bags just so I can be a bit more organized when it comes to the storage of this clothing, because getting out huge suitcases every single time is just, again, a bit of a faff. So I really wanna have a vacuum bag of like winter clothes, one of summer clothing, so when it comes to my summer clothing capsule rejig, it can be a little bit easier. So I'll let you know how I get on with those. But because I have gone through everything, there are a couple of items that I will be popping in the charity bag. This is from Another Stories, and it's a really gorgeous cashmere knit. In fact, I reckon I might pop this one to like my mum or my auntie. I think they would really love this. There's something about the bottle green that last year I wore it a ton, probably one of my most worn knitwear pieces. This year, I've maybe worn it once, which is just such a shame. It's a really gorgeous piece, can definitely go to a new home. These are a pair of redone jeans that I purchased in the sale in the same size that I've got the rest of my redone jeans. They are too small for me and I just need to accept that. Obviously something to do with the dyeing process of these, they're just a lot smaller, but then they didn't have the size up available when I came to exchange them. So I was like, oh, I'll just keep them, it'll be fine. Like, I'll tone up, yeah. That's not happening. Have you seen my double chin? So I just need to accept that it's not happening anytime soon. They're super uncomfortable to wear. I feel like a sausage with like too much sausage stuffing when I wear them. So these going in a charity bag. These are from a while ago, actually. They're a pair of Under the Stories leather trousers. They're not the leather trousers, I must stress. They're not the leather trousers that I've worn all winter. These are a slightly different pair that are more closely cut, and I just haven't really ever worn them, which is so silly. Actually, I might pop these on the little charity sale Depop if you're interested. I feel like we could raise a bit of money for these. These weren't cheap for me to buy, so I will do that. I feel kind of sad, but both pairs of my dungarees I'm gonna put in the charity bag, which really shocks me because a couple of years ago I wore dungarees all the time, but for the last 2 years I really haven't worn them that much. These ones are from Madewell, and because I didn't have a pair of white jeans at the time, I wore these underneath things as a white jean with a jumper over the top. But yeah, for the last 2 years, I really haven't got the wear out of these that I should have. So it's a sad day, but I'm saying goodbye. This is a coat from Jigsaw. I think this was very kindly gifted, which is very nice of them. But again, I just haven't really worn it that much. It's sort of, it's a tricky one. It's quite a transitional jacket, and I sort of have other favorites in that transitional jacket category, so I do not find myself wearing this too often. And then two tops. This one is a recent buy, actually. This was from Mango last year. I love the shape of it. I love the tone of it. However, it just is so booby. And even if I got the straps shortened somewhat, then it just looks a bit strange, like having a V-neck up really, really high. I just really, really struggled to wear this. I felt like I was exposing my boobs to everyone. And because it was so low cut, it's really hard to wear a bra under it. And yeah, that wasn't my best purchase. And that's okay. We make mistakes sometimes. Again, I'm sure it'll find a good home. And then this, I can't believe I'm getting rid of this, but this is an Equipment leopard print shirt. I've had this maybe for about 3 years. It's silk, it's gorgeous. There's absolutely nothing wrong with it. Again, this is one I'll pop into the charity sale if any of you are interested. A gorgeous piece, but I just don't find myself wearing a gray and black leopard print that often. If I'm going to wear leopard print, it's more of a warm leopard print. So popping this on the pile, but that was a good declutter. That actually feels really good to do. I'm not gonna lie, I was kind of dreading this video. I had to like G myself up for it by putting on leggings for Pete's sake, but I'm so pleased I did it. I didn't want to do it because I just knew how much there was to go through for me anyway. This feels like I'd accumulated a bit too much clothing and I just needed to take a breath. So hopefully this has inspired you guys to have a bit of a declutter. Let me know how you get on. I'm not sure this video is particularly instructional in that kind of way, but if you are interested in having a wardrobe declutter, I do have a book. You can get it on Kindle now. I'll put the link to it down below, and I'm sure there's a couple of blog posts that I've done on this topic as well, so I'll link that down below if you want something that is a little bit easier to digest. So yeah, declutter, capsule wardrobe, and a mini haul all in one. Hopefully you enjoyed this. I hope you're all staying safe. I hope you're all keeping well. And if you need a good staying in activity, decluttering your wardrobe is definitely one of those things to get out the way, tick off, and feel great once you've done it. But keep well, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.